First thing I did was chisel out a little bit of wood along the top of the stock here to fit this butt plate approximately where it's going to be on the back of this buttstock. I also scribed across where I have to file this brass to make it somewhat square to this hole. So you see I have it pretty much where it's going to be when it's bolted to the stock. Now, next thing I have to do is mark this wood here and cut some of this stock away, which I hate doing, but unfortunately I have to do it, to get this butt plate to fit in tight against the wood. Now, after that's done and I get this tight, I will put blue painter's tape around the stock, and like I always like doing, I'll take paint and mark where I have to file off. Put it aside, let it dry, take the butt plate off, and then I know to file the paint away, and that'll leave me with the size of the metal that I need to cover the end of the buttstock. All right, you see that this butt plate's a little bit too wide for the end of the stock. So what I did is I secured it to where it's gonna be. I protected the stock with blue tape and then put some paint around to mark the metal that I have to take off. Then I'll remove this butt plate when this paint is dry and file away the paint and, you know, reattach it to the back of the buttstock and do the final fitting that I have to do to make it fit nice and tight to the wood. All right, this is the reproduction Brown Best butt plate that I carved down to fit the Brunswick rifle. This is an original butt plate right here, and you can see the difference in size. And this reproduction was originally this size, so I had to mark it and remove metal to get it to the right width to fit onto the Brunswick rifle. So you see how much, approximately how much metal had to come off of this to make it fit the other rifle. Now, to get it to fit tightly to the back, what I did was I took some makeup that my wife had, and make sure you ask your wife first before you grab her makeup. It was okay with her. And on the places that are a little bit smoother, you're gonna have to put a little makeup to make this blue powder, which is from chalk line powder, stick. And then you'll put some powder on here where you believe it's touching on the stock, and you'll screw it back on and then take it off, and wherever the powder is touching the wood, then you know you have to remove some of that wood. And don't be real greedy grinding off the wood. Do a little at a time. You may have to do it a dozen or 15 times to get it, and then you can get it really super tight by doing it a little at a time. And what I used was files. They're actually metal working files. And you will have to clean them a little with something, because every time you carve off a little wood, they're gonna load up. And I would just use a toothbrush, and you can use a file card too, and get the wood out of the cutting edge of the file. And you just do it a little at a time until you fit the butt plate. And if you look, you can see I got it very tight. You just have to have patience. Let me get the tape out of here. You just have to have patience and do it and take your time, and you'll fit it and you won't have any gap. And in the old days, they would use like lamp black or some kind of charcoal, and you know, that was their medium that they used to show where the metal was touching. And I just had this powder from the chalk line. I used that, and that worked fine. So that's how you get it to fit tight, and that's how you get it to be the right width. So you can need a little tape, a little latex paint, leftover latex paint, and a file, and some patience. All right, I want to show the final fitting of this patch box and the part I made and how I repaired the top of this butt plate. how I completed it. So first off, show how it works. It's got this spring loaded. So it snaps into place. And this butt plate, what we did is we soldered the piece I made to the top. And when you do solder, it's soldered from the top down so that the solder puddles up underneath. And I'll show you what I mean for strength. Part. Now when I soldered it, from this side, and then all the solder puddled up under here and gave this strength. So this is pretty strong now. And then I mortised in the top so it fits good. And then for this, I just took a piece of brass and soldered it to a piece of quarter stock, and then shaped it and cut a notch in it. I'll show you how I did that. And then just attached it with two small screws to the back, and the brass gave plenty of spring tension. So I just took a piece of this and then just shaped it and gave a little relief here where it touched up against this butt plate, and then you had room to be able to pull it. Put a notch in there where it caught onto the plate, and I made it out of this stock. And then this I made out of this thin brass, and I soldered one of these brass hinges to it, so I made a nice patch box cover. And I just put a little spring in there to keep it, so when you pull it, it pops open. But there's the completed butt plate right there. Just got to do a little more polish and get a few scratches out of it, and we're good.
All right.
This is the finished gun that I put together. I'm going to show how I added the piece along the top. And here's the patch box cover, all fit. And here's the latch I made with a spring to pop up. And here we go. This is the other part I made right there. That's the brass washer. The other thing was the finish that I got to try to match the finish of the original guns. And I'll bring an original gun to show you that I got the color and the sheen of the wood pretty close. Now, here's a Martini Henry, and it's a pretty close match as far as the sheen of the wood and the stain. But if we move down here, I fit in all the brass and the end cap. I cleaned the metal up, got all the keepers in, and now it's a complete gun. The stain I used was the Minwax English Chestnut number 233. The finish I used was from Home Depot. It was bare and was a water-based polyurethane matte. I'm very happy with the way this rifle turned out, and I'd like to thank you for watching the four-part videos of the rifle restoration. And please like and subscribe and share. It would be very helpful. Thank you very much.